Hey everybody, welcome into this Adobe Premiere Pro tutorial brought to you as always by tutvid.com. My name is Nathaniel Dodson, and today we're going to take a quick look at creating simple scrolling credits for the end of your film, your movie, your video production. It's pretty easy to do here in Premiere Pro. I did an older tutorial on it where we used sort of the legacy titler in Adobe Premiere Pro, but now in the newer version of Premiere Pro, there's actually a bunch of different ways we can do it. I'm going to show you three ways. I think you're really going to enjoy it. Let's jump into this tutorial right away and get this thing started. Well, alrighty, here we are in Adobe Premiere Pro, and we're going to take a look at some rolling credits. So let's get started with the Essential Graphics panel first. Up here under Window, we have Essential Graphics. Now, this is newer to Photoshop CC, I think 2017, I want to say, something like that. But if you don't have Essential Graphics, don't worry, you just don't have it. But if you do, you've got it. I guess that's a little bit of an understatement, but you get what I'm saying. Use the legacy titler or check out my other tutorial on scrolling credits if you don't have the Essential Graphics. Now, here in Essential Graphics, we actually have an entire folder. This is default. It comes with Premiere Pro called Credits. And I feel a little dumb even showing it because it's pretty straightforward, but you know what? I'd be remiss if I didn't show it because it is that straightforward. I'm going to go with just the bold credits here. I'm going to drag it, drop it on my timeline here above Tat Guy, and it's going to say, look, this project uses fonts that are not currently available on this computer. Font substitution will occur. I'm going to say, okay, no worries. That's fine. I'm going to go in and probably change the fonts anyway. I'm going to close Essential Graphics for a second because I'm actually going to drag this up one layer because we want to create... Basically, we want to make the text easy to read over the video, and we're going to do that by, over here in our project bin, we are going to create something new. We're going to hit the New Item tab or button here, and we're going to choose a color matte, and I'm going to say everything's fine with that. I'm going to go with solid black, hit OK, and I can name it whatever I want. In fact, I'm going to name it overlay because that's what it is, and here is overlay. I'm going to drag overlay out and place it on my timeline above Tat Guy, and I'm going to stretch it out to be as long as Tat Guy is. Wow, look at those. Look at that font for our credits. We're going to change that, though. Right now, I'm worried about the overlay, and I still want to be able to see the Tat Guy video behind it. So I'm going to select the overlay track. You can see, well, I'm actually selecting the overlay object, and I'm just going to reduce the opacity. I'm going to just shut off the animation aspect of this because I want to change the opacity for the entire thing. Don't change. Let's go like 75%, see what that looks like. Maybe we'll make it a little darker. Let's go like 85. I think 85 will work for us. Let's work with these credits now that we have this overlay. So I'm going to select Company Presents, and you can see here in Effect Controls, we have a bunch of stuff that comes up. I think it'll be easier here if we bring back the Essential Graphics panel, and we work here under the Edit option. So right there, we have Edit in Essential Graphics, because what we can do is we can select all of these layers of text. I'm holding down Shift, selecting all of them, and I don't want to use this Paul Mall, bizarro-looking typeface. I do know I have Bebas on my computer, which is right... Hey, where did it go? There it is, right there, which it was saying that I didn't have, but I do. And I'm going to set it to probably like bold, something like that. And you can see we have everything as this nice bold effect. If I deselect, you can see that's kind of a cool little block of credits, right? And at that point, you would go in and you would choose layer by layer here, Company Presents. And you could, this could be, you know, you click out here, or I should say double click out here, and then you can, you know, double click on an individual word if you want. You can say My Company Presents, or, you know, whatever, Blue Hen, or whatever the name of your company is. You can select that and type in whatever you like for all of these different lines of text and build out the credits you want. Now, here's the important thing about this. So you have all these different things that you can mess around with in terms of alignment and sizing and stuff like that, appearance. You can change the color. Maybe you don't want it to be white. Maybe you want it to be something else, or you want this to be 100%, not 87% in terms of your opacity. But most importantly here, if we just come up here, you can see we have a piece of text selected. If I just click in here to deselect that, I have this option here, intro and outro duration, but also the option to roll. So I'm going to say, yeah, let's roll this. We're just going to start our animation on screen and just end it off screen. You can play with your pre and post roll and your easing in and easing out to get something exactly like you would want. But basically, it's going to begin wherever we have the start of our text object or our credits text object, and it'll start off screen, and it will take the duration of that object and make sure that it's ending off screen. So if you want it to travel a little bit more slowly, we'll simply stretch that text object out, maybe something like that, and I can go ahead and play through this. We can see the credits are just going to scroll up nice and slowly. Now, this process can be a little glitchy. Sometimes you'll begin playing and the credits just won't be there. You can see here this time, for some reason, they're not showing up. I don't know if that's like a Premiere Pro bug, and then as you can see, as soon as I click on it, it shows up, and I don't know. I don't quite know what's going on there, but you do have these credits built in, and you can mess around with them, and you can customize them quite a bit, and it's just a nice, quick and easy starting point for you. I'm going to delete these credits, and I am going to show you how to export some credits from Photoshop and bring them over here into Premiere as well if you prefer doing it that way. So I have all these credits that I've written down in this rich text format where it's basically directed by, written by, produced by, all that. And then the sort of associated names that would go, it was directed by Darlene Estrada and written by Casey Simpson and so on and so forth. So all of that, all this information. And what I've done is I've gone over to Photoshop and I've laid it out in this Photoshop document. Now, I will show, I'll do a tutorial at some point on how to just put together a quick credits package and do all the alignment and stuff in Photoshop. But for now, I'm just going to show you how to export the proper file type and get it over into Premiere so you can use it. So I have all of these layers. They're all text layers here. I don't want the black background, though. I want that text to show up over my video. Now, the first thing is I created a document. If I go up to image, image size, the document is 1920 wide. The height doesn't matter because we're going to scroll it. We're going to animate it by the width. You want it to be the width of your frame. So if you're working with 2560 by 1440 video, you want this to be 2560 pixels wide. But we're working with video that's 1920 by 1080. So that's first and foremost. Then what I'll do is I'll just select all the text by shift clicking and, you know, select the bottom layer, select the top layer, and I'm going to group this. So I'm going to hit Command or Control G to group it. I'll just name this credits or something. And check this out. We can just right click on the layer group and choose to export this as. When we do this, we're going to get this where it's just solid white. And what's happening is Photoshop saying, look, you want to export this as a JPEG. Right here, JPEG, and you've got this transparent background because we're not exporting the black background. The default for a background for JPEG, because you can't get transparency in a JPEG, is white. So we would just be getting a solid white image. That's no good, obviously. We want a PNG. And a PNG we can tick on, yeah, give us some transparency. And you can see if I zoom in, there's text there. It's difficult to read over the transparent checkerboard background, but once it's over our darkened video, it's going to be easy to read. Now, we have a problem here because the width is only 1521. We want this to be 1920 just so there's no questions, no thought, no worry, no nothing, if I can speak grammatically and correctly for a moment, when it comes time to drag this into our video. How do we do that? Well, there's a little workaround here, and maybe there's a better way to do this, but this is the way I've always done it. You can just slap a layer mask on the layer or layer group by hitting this new layer mask button, and now when I export this, it's going to maintain the original file width and everything. I need to go back and say, give me that PNG format. There it is, 1920 by 5,000 pixels, and I can just export this, and I'll just save it as credits.png in the folder. I'll save that, let it go, and I'll jump back over to Premiere. And here from Premiere, really, I should jump out to the Finder, I guess. And there's my credits.png file. So I'll drag that, I'll drop it here in my project bin. And this is pretty easy, right? We just drag this out and drop it on our timeline like so. We could maybe stretch it out to about right there. And what I want to do here is create a simple animation where this begins and scrolls its way up. So what I'm going to do is use positioning here and just push this way down. I want to push it down until it's off screen. So something like that. So there I am, about 3596 pixels. It'll be, you know, it just all depends on the length of your image. This is going to be different for everyone. I'm going to hit the little stopwatch here to begin animating. Then I'll just bring this, you know, basically all the way to the end. Maybe I'll stop right before the end. And I'm just going to scroll the text up. So I'm just going to keep going until all the text has passed me by and it's gone off the top of the screen, just like that. And now if I play through this, we can see we just have our credits. They're just rolling right on by, and they're going to just keep on flowing as our video in the back just fades to black, and it's just a nice, quick, and easy way. You know, most of the time for this is taken up creating the layout you want in Photoshop, but once you got it, you've got it. So I'm going to select that, I'm going to delete that, and last but not least, we're going to do our own custom layout using Essential Graphics again, but really, it begins here with the text tool. So I'm going to grab the text tool, and actually, before I do anything with the text tool, let's copy our first block of text here, and I'm going to go just with these names here. I'm going to keep it simple, so I'm going to select that grouping of names, and then I'm going to click out here, maybe drag out a text box like that, and I'm going to say production colon, and then I'm going to paste all the names in just like that. All right, and what I can do here, actually, I probably should have undo. I don't want to add that second text field. What I think I want to do here is just kind of crunch this text field down a little bit, maybe. Just kind of pinch it in around our text a little bit like that. All right, so I'll begin this text maybe somewhere right around there. That looks good. And you can see over here in Effect Controls, we have sort of a text layer that's been created. I'm going to go back out to my text edit, and I'm going to grab the next chunk of people. Oh, no, not that. We want the names, because this is just going to, I'm just going to go with like, hey, this is the cast, right? So we'll drag out another text field, and I'm going to say the cast. Right, so it's just a matter of, you know, if you know how to copy and paste, you're going to be just fine when it comes to this step. And, you know, make sure we get all the names here. I'll drag out the text field until I have all the names, something like that. And then this text field, I'm going to offset it. I'm going to place it, like, down here. Maybe the idea would be kind of the second to last name of the text block before aligns with the heading for the next sort of row of credits or something like that. I think we'll actually randomize it a little bit. I'm just going to pinch this in here on the right. I'll just have to make sure that I'm not cutting off any text as it goes down a little bit further. Maybe I'll just stretch it out a little bit just to be safe. I'm going to jump back out to my text file here, and we will go with, I'm just going to select this camera and just all of that. We have all the names and everything baked in, so I'm just going to live with that. That's fine. Again, if you're doing it for your film, you may want to be a little bit more particular, and hey, more power to you if you do that. All right, so there's camera, director of photography, so on and so forth. What I may do here is select all this text and just size it down a little bit. Oh, I selected the wrong text field there. Here we go. This is the one you can see text. It says camera, director of photography, so on and so forth. I am going to size the text down in here a little bit. Let me scroll down here. What I'm going to do, I'm going to select this again. We're going to select the text that we want to size down, and we will go ahead and size this down. There we go. Something like that. That's what I want to do. I'm going to keep going until it's kind of all, it all kind of fits within our box. There we go. Something like that I think is going to work for us. And I'm going to grab my normal selection tool. I'm going to just, you know, bump this up. And again, this is all just, you know, have a little bit of fun with it. Obviously, we're breaking our rule here in terms of lining things up because I'm starting to think maybe we'll do more of just a totally random layout. And that's fine, too. I'm going to go back to my text edit. I'm going to grab my last couple bits of text, and I'm just going to build this out really quickly here. You can see I've sped the video up. No worries, though. You're not missing anything. You're able to see what I'm doing, and I've already kind of explained everything that needs to be explained. And we'll be back at the rest of what we're working on creating here in just a moment. So I think we'll stop there. We get enough credits built in, right? And we have a few different layers of text, and maybe in your real project, you don't want to make anybody's name necessarily smaller because maybe it'll make them feel like, hey, but I did stuff too, right? Which they did, but you know, we're just making our layout here. I'm going to drag that over just a little bit. All right, so here's where kind of the magic happens with regard to this type of effect. We can once again go Window, open up Essential Graphics here. I'm going to go to my Edit panel. I have the object selected on my timeline. This is that text object. I can stretch it out as long as I want, let's say. Maybe I won't go quite that far. That's a little obscene. I'm just going to go to like here. And if we don't have any layers selected, we can roll this entire grouping of graphics that we just created. So I can just say, hey, look, roll. Start off screen, end off screen, and let's check to see what we got. So it's pretty cool, and it's just going to obviously roll right on through. And again, if you wanted to make it a little bit slower, you could stretch the object out, and you can add more layers and layers and layers of text. And by the way, if you do prefer the old title, you can always go File, New, and choose the Legacy Title option, and you can bring that up and work with that. But this new text tool makes it really, really easy to go in and quickly tweak and adjust and build out a nice little set of credits for the end of your video project, all done right here in Premiere Pro, with the exception of the one where we jumped over into Photoshop. But pretty much all done right here in Adobe Premiere Pro. So there you have it. When you're looking to add some creative or nice little credits to your film project, it's really not that bad. A bunch of different ways you can do it. I hope you enjoy this video tutorial. And if you did, consider supporting my channel and, well, subscribing. I guess it's not really supporting the channel, but it's just kind of showing a little love. That's all I'm saying. If you enjoyed it, show a little love. If Discord's your kind of thing, you can check out our Discord, discord.me/tutvid, where the conversation just goes on and on and on. For working with a PNG, for working with the new text tools here in Premiere Pro, and also the Essential Graphics panel to create a myriad of different titles for your film, movie, video editing project. That's it. Get it, got it, good. Nathaniel Dodson, tutvid.com. I'll catch you in the next one. And before you go, make sure you subscribe to my channel for more great tutorials every day. Also, buy my course. It helps us do what we do, and this channel is supported by viewers just like you. You can also just click the thumbnail and watch another video from this channel. See you next time, guys.